Good morning, third class children. All of you open your mathematics course book, children. All of you open page number 24. See, children, this is your new chapter, that is fractions. Okay, this is a new chapter, that is fractions. Fractions means fractions are equal parts of a shape. Fractions are equal parts of a shape. Okay, numerator says the number of pieces you have or the number of parts that are shaded. Okay, see children, means suppose if you take one cake, if you take one cake, in a cake, see here children, this is a cake. So one cake had taken, children. So here I have take four parts. That cake have done four parts. Okay, now first piece was completed, means this part is completed. So remaining how many parts do you have? Three parts do you have. So by observing this figure, first how many parts do you have? We are having four parts. How many are shaded? Means shaded means completed part. How many parts are completed? One part is completed. So the answer is 1/4. Okay children, you understand? Means the numerator. Numerator means the upper number. This number is called numerator. The down number is called denominator. The upper number is called numerator and down number is called denominator. Okay children, you understand? Now numerator says the number of pieces you have or the number of parts that are shaded. Okay, now I shaded one part, no sir, that's why I written 1 in the numerator place. Next, denominator means, a denominator says the total number of pieces or the total number of parts. Means how many parts do you have? Total 4 parts, that's why I written in the denominator place. Okay children, do you understand? Total how many parts do you have? 4. So write 4 in the denominator place, and how many shaded part? 1 part is shaded, so 1 you have to write in the numerator. Next, do you understand children? Now let us try to recall what we learn above fractions. Okay, introduction part completed, no children? Now come to the down one. See children, here they have given some figures to you, some different types of shapes they have given, children. What is the question they have given? Write the fraction by observing the shaded portion. Write the fraction by observing the shaded portion. Means here shaded, what is the in a fraction they have shaded one part, none. That one we had to write. Okay, now first see children, see the first figure. How many parts do you have? 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. So we are having total 5 parts. How many are shaded? 1, 2. 2 are shaded. So answer is 2/5. Sum. Next one. How many parts do you have? 1, 2, 3, 4. So total 4 parts. How many parts are shaded? 1. So 1/4. Next. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12, 13, 14, 15, 16, 17, 18, 19, 20, 21, 22, 23, 24. Total you have 24 parts. How many parts are shaded? Why? Because here they have given shaded portion, that's why. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12. So 12 are shaded. Okay children, do you understand? Now come to the next one children. How many parts do you have? 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. Total 8 parts. How many are shaded? 1, 2, 3. 3 parts are shaded. So answer is 3/8. Okay, now come to the next one children. See the next one. Shade the portion indicated by the fraction given below each figure. Shade the portion indicated by the fraction given below each figure. In the first one they have given shaded. Now we here we have to shade it. Nana, in the question already they have shaded and given. Now here we have to shade. Okay. Now see children, total how many parts do you have? 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. So the total parts they have written in 5 in the denominator place. Now 3 in the numerator place. So how many parts we have to shade? Nana, 3 parts. Now all of you shade 3 parts. Shade the 3 parts, children. Okay. Now come to the next one. How many parts do you have? Total 8 parts. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. So how many parts I had to shade? 5 parts I had to shade, children. So shade 5 parts. Okay. Now come to the next one. 3, 2 by 3. See here, 1, 2, 3. So total 3 parts. Now how many parts I have to shade? 2 parts. Now all of you shade 2 parts, children. At a time I am shading, Nana, 2 parts. Okay. Now come to the next one. How many parts do you have? 10 parts. Count here, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10. So total 10 parts. Now how many parts I had to shade? 8 parts. So now shade 8 parts, children. Like this, you have to shade all the 8 parts. Okay, children, do you understand? So you also shade your book. So total 8 parts are completed. Completed or not? Yes, total 8 parts are completed. Okay, children, do you understand? Now all of you turn the page. Now all of you open page number 25, children. See, children, see the question. Write the numerator and denominator of the following fractions. Write the numerator and denominator of the following fractions. Here they have given fractions, Nana. For these fractions we had to write down the numerator and denominator separately. Okay. See the fraction, first fraction, what they given? 5 by 12. So the upper part is called numerator and down part is called denominator. So numerator place how much we had to write here, children? Now 5. Denominator place 12. Same process. 8 by 25. Numerator is 8. Denominator is 25. Next 23 by 35. So which is the numerator? 23 is the numerator and 35 is the denominator. Next 7 by 23. So 7 is the numerator and 23 is the denominator. Okay, children, do you understand? Now come to the next sum. Write the fractions for the given numerator and denominator. Write the fractions for the given numerator and denominator. In the first question they have given fraction part and they told to write numerator and denominator, children. But in this question they have given numerator and denominator. Now we had to find out the fraction part. Okay. So see the children, which is, what is the numerator? 3. Denominator 11. So answer is 3 by 11. Now here, what is the numerator? 6 is the numerator and 22 is the denominator. So answer is 6 by 22. Next one is 8 to 13. So by observing these two, what we have to write? 8 is in the numerator place and 13 is in the denominator place. So the answer is 8/13. The next one, what is the next number they have given? 4, 7. So in the numerator place we had to write 4 and denominator place we had to write 7. So answer is 4/7. Okay, now come to the next one, 14, 20. So numerator place how much we had to write, children? 14, and denominator place 20. So the answer is 14/20. Okay, children, do you understand Anna? Now come to the next one, Anna. Next topic is observe these fractions. Of we can represent it 1/2. Of we can write as 1/2, children. So children, see, children, here what they given? They have given junk fruit. Junk fruit they have cut, Nana, into two equal parts. So each part is represented as 1/2. See why we written 1/2. Here we are having two parts, but it is totally one part, one fruit only, no? So that's why we make an off, means two, one fruit we make in two parts. So that's why the answer is 1/2. Okay, children, like this we had to write. Come to the next one. Muskmelon is cut into two equal parts. Here they have given one muskmelon, Nana. That one also cut into two parts. So that's why, so each part is represented by 1/2. So each part is represented by 1/2. The next one, egg. Egg is divided into two equal parts. Do you know egg, Nana? Yes. Boiled egg. Means boiled egg we have make at two parts. So when we are making two parts, it presented 1/2. So that's why, children, 1/2 means it is known as off. Okay, off we can has 1/2. Otherwise, HALF also we can write. Okay, children, do you understand? In this class, we have learned about numerator and denominators and fractions, how we had to represent. Okay, children, in the next class, I'll continue some more sums to you. Thank you. Have a nice day.